control freaks have come in, you know, the tyranny has come in. You can't do this. You can't do this. All this control. Same thing happens in marriages. We control our partners. Anytime you're unhappy with your partner, that is a control mechanism. It's a primitive control mechanism. If we are loving human beings, the yes. only reason we're not feeling love and gratitude and happiness and excitement and enthusiasm and pride, all those things, is because we haven't conditioned our brain to awaken those channels. They're all in our brain. They're in my brain. And as soon as anything upsets me, I just shift. I shift gears. I become aware of what I'm feeling, and I go deeper into the feeling very quickly. Anytime you're angry, you're also afraid. Yeah. Anytime you're sad, you're also feeling guilty. You're not really able to look at it. So look at how I wish I could be. I'm not being that. You go to those levels of feeling that I teach in my book, right? In that What You Feel, You Can Heal book. And yes. miraculously, you feel better. And then positive feelings can come up. So I go from the negative to then affirm. I'm grateful. I'm happy. I'm excited. And I'm proud. See, these four levels would be anger. The opposite of anger is gratitude. Okay, I'm so grateful about this and this. So you can be angry about this over here, but you can yes. be grateful for this over there. So they can live together. The world's not a perfect place. You know, the old yeah. saying, the glass is half full, or glass is half empty. It's both, you know, life is never perfect, but there's always good stuff. And you only go into stress and unhappiness and negativity and judgmentalness and criticalness and vengeance and poor communication, all this primitive stuff, when you're not balancing your negative view with your positive view. And that has nothing to do with your partner, has nothing to do with the world, the state of the situation. It has to do with your inability to know your true self. And that's what people want today through intimacy. We need intimacy. And those that have achieved some intimacy, if you can sustain it, then you get the glory of what's called self-actualization, a self-actualized person. Once you're a self-actualized person, then you experience unconditional love and compassion. That's my state of being. But I'm 70 years old. It took a long time to get there. So much wisdom, so much fun. You know, I used to feel dread a bit with my counseling clients because I felt like they're so stuck, I can't solve their problems. And now I have so much wisdom. It's so easy to solve their problems. It's just, first of all, the most important thing is to realize people make up all their problems. So all you have to do is help them realize how they're making up their problems and a way to stop doing that. And that's what my books are, is these strategies and helpful things. And to hold the awareness that people come in with the worst problems and they think I'll never be happy because of this problem and this problem. I go, I already know. Yes, you can be happy. You can't change the past and you can't change the world to be everything you want it to be. But you can change this negativity inside of you because who you are is already grateful and happy and excited and proud. You have a lot to be proud about. So it's there. It's already there. It's just leading someone back to that. And that's what in my book, What You Feel, You Can Heal, first book I wrote, very simple book of having emotional intelligence that's way beyond what the other books are saying is emotional intelligence. And those other books are very good, but they still don't teach people how to process those emotions so that you can then begin to understand reality and accept it and then make the best of it, which I've done in all my books. My first book being How to Process Emotions. People say, how did you learn all this stuff? Whenever there was stress, I took 100% responsibility. I came back to feeling love. And then when you come back to place of love, you come back to place of wisdom, non-judgmentalness, and creativity. You have the creativity to solve the problem. So ultimately, self-actualization is great, but if the foundation for it, meaning what self-actualization is to feel aligned with your mission and purpose and fulfilled and stress-free. You know, I used to always wonder, who are these people that wake up and just look forward to their day and they love it, you know? I just wake up and can't wait to go to work, okay? That's self-actualized. That is a really healthy person, you know, when you love your work and you feel you're contributing to others and you love your partner and you love your family and your sex drive is healthy, all those aspects as a whole being, and we can all have it. And, you know, to talk to somebody and read books of people that have achieved it is really, really shortcutting the whole process. So I'm really glad that I can be a shortcut for some people.